Hello, and welcome to today's video where I'll be covering my webcomic process in Clip Studio Paint. In today's video, we'll be discussing more about Clip Studio Paint's 3D models and how they can be used to easily create backgrounds for your webcomic. Links to related tutorials will be down in the description box below. Drawing backgrounds for your webcomic is something many artists find intimidating, as it can be difficult to balance making a background that looks good, but also doesn't take too long to create. Thankfully, Clip Studio Paint has a library of 3D backgrounds that you can use to make your webcomic look professional in just a few steps. To find these, go to the Materials panel and look for a subfolder called Background under the 3D folder. Here you can pick a background that suits your needs, then drag and drop it onto your canvas. Once you've placed the background, you can use the camera tools to rotate, zoom, and position your background until it looks how you'd like it. If there are any objects in the background that you'd like to remove or adjust individually, you can select them by going to the Tool Property panel and clicking the dropdown where the background name is listed. By expanding this dropdown, you can isolate any specific object and choose whether to leave it visible or if you want to target it for adjustment. Clip Studio Paint also allows you to import your own 3D models and create simple rigs for them if you'd like to use something more customized. To import your own model, just go to File, Import, 3D Data, and follow the prompts. Links to related videos on the subject are down in the description below. You can make further adjustments to your background in the Tool Property panel as well. The Perspective slider lets you control the depth of perspective, which can create some unique effects depending on your needs. The camera position sliders let you individually nudge the background along the X, Y, and Z axes for tighter control of the camera. The apply light source box allows you to switch the lights on and off. By clicking and rotating the sphere in the center of the panel, you can control where the light source is placed. The layout options let you make further small adjustments based on presets unique to your 3D model. In this example, we could control the color of the furniture and rotate the door and chair. The outline width box lets you create a bold outline around all of the objects in the background, which you can adjust the width of using the slider below. This is a really helpful feature for anyone using these backgrounds as a reference, as it can help you see where to place your line art on another layer. You may want to add in some additional 3D models. In the 3D folder of the Materials Library, you can find a subfolder called Small Object that has lots of objects ready to be placed into your scene. With your 3D background layer selected, drag the small object onto your canvas and it'll automatically fit itself into the same perspective. Now you can click on the object and adjust its position. You can add as many objects to a scene as you like, so really go wild on how you customize your scene. You can find additional 3D models and assets by going to the Clip Studio Assets page. There's lots of free-to-use models here that'll work for any type of story, so take a look and see what works for your needs. For my webcomic, Darley and the Magician's Key, I've downloaded a lot of useful assets to help with making medieval fantasy-type scenery, like wagons, horses, and lanterns. After placing your background and setting it up how you like, there are lots of options available for what to do from there. Some artists like the look of a 3D background by itself, while others use it as a base and draw line art above it. You can also use Clip Studio Paint's filters to add effects that make the backgrounds look more distinct. In a future video, I'll discuss how you can extract line art directly from 3D backgrounds using Clip Studio Paint EX's Line Extract function. So if that topic is helpful to you, be sure to check back on the Clip Studio Paint YouTube channel for more info. Those are the basics for how to use Clip Studio Paint's 3D models to create backgrounds for your webcomic. Check the description below for my social media links and more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.